Boy, what a weird dream. I was on a plane, and I dreamed that the captain came over the loudspeaker and said something like, "Prepare for landing. We're on our way to see Steve Hayes, tired old queen at the movies."
Sean!
Tired old queen at the movies.
Johnny, we haven't done a film noir in a while, so I thought let's start the new year off right and get going. So I chose from 1948 John Huston's version of Maxwell Anderson's Key Largo, starring Humphrey Bogart, Edward G. Robinson, Lauren Bacall, Lionel Barrymore, and in her Academy Award-winning performance, Claire Trevor. This is from a Broadway play, written in verse by Maxwell Anderson that had been a quasi-hit on Broadway. And 1948 was a big year for John Huston. He directed The Treasure of the Sierra Madre, which got his father an Academy Award, and he directed this, which got Claire Trevor an Academy Award. He won the Oscar for Best Director for Sierra Madre, so it was a big, big year at the Oscar for the Huston family.
Worth what it is because of the human labor that went into the finding and the getting of it.
Never thought of it just like that.
Well, there's no other explanation, mister. Gold and stuff ain't good for nothing except making jewelry with gold teeth. Gold's a devilish sort of a thing anyway.
Bogart is a returning GI, and one of his buddies who was killed next to him, he's going to visit the guy's father and his widow who run a hotel on Key Largo. And this is when the Keys were not particularly settled. They were still pretty wild down there. And even though it's the off-season and it's hurricane season, they already have some guests.
Oh, Major, I want you to meet Mr. Bass.
Garcia.
This gangster named Johnny Rocco, played by Edward G. Robinson.
I need your advice, I ask for it.
And he's a nasty, nasty piece of work, and he's got his henchman, and he's got his girlfriend. He's picked up on the way, Gay Dawn, who used to be a singer and is now this alcoholic floozy, played by Claire Trevor.
I think I'll have a scotch and water, please.
Oh.
Automatically, as soon as Bogart gets there, he senses that there's a lot of trouble here. And Johnny Rocco is trying to get a boat and get off to Cuba.
Well, what are we going to do, huh? We can't stay here, can we?
Unfortunately, a hurricane hits and they're trapped there. They end up killing a policeman. As the storm heightens, so does the drama inside. This is also about the restlessness of GIs who came home from the war. And, after seeing what they had seen in Europe, the world was never going to be the same again for them. And trying to express that and convey that to people who hadn't been there. And suddenly Bogart, who has been sort of restless and trying to adjust back into normality, is thrust into this dangerous situation in which he has to utilize that same stuff he had to survive in when he was fighting the war in Europe. And the war is right there in that hotel.
You figure it's the gun? Well, listen, soldier. Thousands of guys got guns, but there's only one Johnny Rocco.
How do you account for it? Well, he knows what he wants, don't you, Rocco?
Sure. What's that?
Tell him, Rocco.
Well, I want,
He wants more, don't you, Rocco?
Yeah, that's it. More. That's right, I want more.
Will you ever get enough? Will you, Rocco?
Well, I never have. No, I guess I won't. You, do you know what you want?
Yes, and I had hopes once, but I gave them up.
Hopes for what?
A world in which there's no place for Johnny Rocco.
Every character in this is so good. Old Lionel Barrymore, who was all crippled up with arthritis and, does this role from his wheelchair.
Look at him, the great Johnny Rocco, with Nora's spittle hanging from his face.
Well, shut up, old man.
Come over here. I'd like to spit on you.
Bacall was really learning her craft, and thanks to Bogart, and with each movie getting better and better. And Robinson will always go up to her, and whisper dirty things in her ear, and you don't know what he's whispering to her, but it's really seedy.
Hey,
And Claire Trevor is just this raw nerve of, you know, going through the DTs all the time. And she'll say things to, like, she's always wanting a drink. And Robinson just keeps slapping her around and telling her she can't have one.
You gave me my first drink, Johnny.
Oh, so it's all my fault now. Everybody has their first drink, don't they? But everybody ain't a lush.
If I'd known you was going to act this way, I wouldn't have come here.
I'd have known what you're like. You wouldn't have been asked.
There's this classic scene where he makes her sing this song.
You mean right now?
Yeah.
Claire Trevor said she thought that they were going to have an orchestra and, you know, that there was going to be a piano. And when she came time to shoot it, John Huston said, Claire, I want you to get up and sing this a cappella.
I can't.
And she was not a singer. And she thought maybe she'd be dubbed or something.
Please, Johnny, don't make me.
And she has to get up there as someone with the DTs and sing this old torch song, moaning low, my sweet man is gonna go.
Well?
My gowns were gorgeous. Always low cut, very décolleté.
And she sings it terribly. And it's one of the most raw and painful things to watch.
Don't know any reason why he treats me so poorly. What have I gone and done? Makes my trouble double with his worries when surely I ain't deserving of none.
As she gets halfway through the song, she can't finish it.
Give me that drink now, Johnny.
No.
Johnny.
Johnny.
No.
But you promised.
So what?
You said that.
But you were right.
So Bogart goes over and hands her a drink. She goes, thanks, mister. She downs the drink and Robinson walks over and...
Thanks, fella.
You're welcome.
It's just high, high tension. The very best film noir. It's photographed in absolutely glorious black and white with lots of shadows, the way noir is meant to be. And the pairing up of these two iconic actors, Bogart and Robinson, was just a brilliant, brilliant teaming. And under John Huston's direction, it just rocks, rolls, and rivets you. Humphrey Bogart, Edward G. Robinson, Lauren Bacall, Lionel Barrymore, and the amazing Claire Trevor in John Huston's Key Largo.
Let's all go to the lobby.
Silence. Well, that wasn't that. It was me. Very sad.
The popcorn can't be beat.